I was always looking for ways to be an active participant in the dialogue of art, to generate energy, and to create a platform for pursuing new ideas. This led me, in the early 80s, to establish the DESTE Foundation for Contemporary Art. DESTE did not start as a collecting institution or as an exhibition program. It began as a concept. Our first project, COCA, Center of Contemporary Culture and Art, encompassed all elements of culture, including visual arts, architecture, music, fashion, design, etc. The idea was to see different art forms in the context of their own environment. This spirit has defined us as projects and has always been an expression of my personal and my professional life. In the beginning, I did not have any desire to collect art, but after seeing in 1985 Jeff Koons' Equilibrium Tank, all that changed. This, of course, is not the time to talk about the collection, but I do want to talk about how my engagement in art, my business projects and personal life are not distinct activities, but they all merge to one another. That led to some extraordinary projects and some extraordinary collaborations. This is the spirit that guided the decision to invite Karim Rashid and the Campana brothers to design two boutique hotels in Athens. As industrial designers, neither had done something like this before. So they brought a fresh thinking into the challenging projects. Karim transformed the Semiramis into an art object. The Campanas worked on the new hotel, recycling the original context, maintaining its 60s character. Both projects have radically broken conventions. Architecture is a way to reimagine the world in new and radical ways. It is an almost infectious discipline, closely related to what collecting means to me. DESTE collaborated on a long-term research project with the Columbia University, the Graduate School of Architecture, to examine the link between architecture and collecting practices. This is a board book of the furniture collection of Italian radical design. It was done in collaboration with Maurizio Cattelan and the Toilet Paper magazine. It's symbolically titled 1968, the year that Utopia started and the year that Utopia ended. It includes some of the most radical thinkers of the day, Superstudio, Sozzas, Gianni Colombo. Fashion does not argue. It simply fascinates. I thought for a long time about how to organize a collection in an area so strongly characterized by the fleeting and the transient. This is an example of the year that Dillo, Scofidio, and Refno did a photo shoot at the Glass House that reflects the formal, the material, and the social economies between art and fashion. On a personal level, when I asked Ivana Porfiri to design a boat for our family, the assignment was very simple. Forget style. Just fit in the space that we need. We ended up with a very uncommon shape for a yacht. When I asked Jeff Koons' opinion, he came up with the idea to cover the exterior with razzle dazzle, the World War I British naval camouflage. He agreed to design it himself. It is a boat reconceived as a floating three-dimensional painting. Our projects have become more porous and more radical through time, but in many ways we have returned to some of our experimental ideas from the early 80s. It has always been a journey to find new ways to encompass different elements of culture without eliminating their individuality. This has always been my vision and my conviction, but I would also say my pleasure. It acts as a creative contagion between business and collecting, between art and life. Through the blue window, you can barely see Jean Nouvel in conversation with Badai, projected on the white walls building. I needed to go through this background in order to put white walls in context. When our family decided to donate a library in honor of my father to the University of Cyprus, we were at the same time planning a high-profile building in the center of Nicosia, facing the Venetian fortifications on a square designed by Zaha Hadid. These two projects had to be meaningful, visually powerful, and in direct dialogue with the environment. They needed to be unique. They needed to be singular objects. I have known Jean Nouvel for some time and somehow felt he was the obvious choice for both. I was very glad that he was willing to take the challenge. You all know Jean, and he certainly does not need my introduction. But I would like to make a couple of observations about his work. He has a special ability to use light like a material, like paint on a canvas. Nobody can manipulate and tame the strong Mediterranean light better than Jean. Then there is the specificity, the singularity of the building he designs and how they connect with their environment. I will start with an anecdote. When we were discussing the brief with the university authorities, one of the requirements was that the buildings have a Cypriot character. After we left, Jean turned to me and said, "Dakis, if they expect arches, you better look for another architect." I told him that I had no doubt that he could find a connection in a more subtle way. These trapezoidal hills only exist in this part of Cyprus around the university. They are called Aronas. So what does this hill have to do with anything? Well, here it is. Jean modeled the library after one of those hills, giving it the Cypriot character. On top is the photograph of the library, which will eventually be covered by fabric, and at the bottom, a trapezoidal hill is seen from the roof. If you were to build the library on the western instead of the eastern part of Nicosia, it would lose its meaning. Connecting architecture with the location, the topos, is not about mimesis of a style or form. It is about catching the spirit and the soul of the place. Similarly, with white walls, if you were to move it just one block away from the Venetian fortifications, its meaning would change. Jean will speak about the white walls in detail, but I would like to make one more point. You may all wonder what this anonymous traditional neoclassical house in Nicosia has to do with white walls. Well, here it is. The plans are almost identical. Again, we have here not a morphological mimesis, but a relationship of structure and type. A heated, non-descriptive, almost invisible relationship with the history of the city and the spirit. This time, the connection with the place, topos, occurs through the type, typos. It is in this context that white walls got its soul. Thank you.
Thank you a lot. Situations. I trust only in the situations. And what I saw, the last project in New York City, in Shanghai, and the project you will see in Nicosia, makes sense in relationship with situations. And they are totally complementary at the scale of the planet today. Situations, look at this map. Look at the situation in Europe of Cyprus. We are in Europe, but we are close to the Turkey, so close, only one wall separates Nicosia in two cities, one city in two cities. That is a special situation. Nicosia, in the middle of Cyprus, Sorry. Nicosia is an old city, and you can see that on the place with the fortifications all around. Look at this concretion with the fortification all around here, and the Somme around also. Here, that is a wall. Here, that is the fortifications. Here, that is a situation where you have to build a tall building. Tall building is 70 meters. But 70 meters in Nicosia is higher than 700 feet in Chicago. And look at that. That is a site. I will go in here. That is a site of the building, and all around the historical city. It's a new city. The new city is done with a lot of modern buildings, and that is in this site that we have to build a building for retail, for offices, for apartments, and with a very special apartment at the top, a penthouse, what is also a little museum for a collector. It's a very specific program, very unique program. But I think situation is also all the variation of the program. Very close of the site, we have the fortifications. In the middle of the fortification, we have the town hall here. And on this site, Zaha Hadid is working. She designed 10 years ago an urban project to create what will be the future center of the city, the main square of the city, in the middle of the fortification, at the border of the ancient city and then the new city. The town hall and the new square designed by Zaha, under construction. And the building is close of that. That is the site of the building. That is the border with the old, with the fortifications. In the middle of that, of this site, we have to build an IOS building, very close of the neighbors' buildings. And on this side, totally open on the historical city and on the vision of the skyline and on the mountains. For this reason, the typology of the city, of the building, is to open the view on the north facade, on the total view, on the historical city with a special typology to have a terrace with some steps to don't see the railing and to see only the landscape, the urban landscape. On each side, we are so close of the other building that the privacy, of course, is very important, but also how to open these walls in relationship with the climate. Sustainability is obviously here. How to use typologies, existing typologies of the linked to the history and to the thickness of the wall and linked to the small windows. So you see the different kinds of facade, north, east, and west. And the south facade will be also totally different. All these walls, all these floors are perforated by little windows. These little windows exist already since centuries in the cities. On this side, we refined something very close of the traditional typology of Nicosia houses. And the interpretation of this typology at the scale of the high-rise building. The high-rise building is done to inhabit. You inhabit when you work in an office. You inhabit when you are in the apartment. You inhabit when you are in your museum, personal museum, when you are at the top of this tower with your city in front of you. Here you see the section, and the south facade is a filter. It's a filter with a complete wall of vegetation. The four differences with the fourth facade is linked also to permanent situations of the building in the world. And I fight since a long time against the clonage of the same buildings parachuted in the cities. Every building needs to have roots, needs to know exactly where it is, needs to know where is the sun. Lateral walls, south wall, and the building in the middle of that belongs to a context, to a modern context, the context of the new city. And when I saw that, I see the building could be like a dungeon with other buildings around belonging to the same story. You see the contrast, of course, with the park in front. And during the night, you feel what is inside, but always protected from the view of the neighbors. And here, building is done to be inhabited and to be done for people living here, like we can live in this kind of climate, for the pleasure to live in a place. And every level of the offices here, every apartment above, are like little houses, are linked totally to the vegetation, to the sun, to the orientation, to the light. On the south facade, you can see its random system. The terraces are never the same. Every level is different. And you have this openness here, and on the side, you have like little patio opening on each side of the apartment, on each side of the offices. You have always a feeling to be in the middle of a house. And sustainability in this case is a comfort to live here naturally. You can open these windows, of course. You can open on the other side with a wind through on the south. You can open on each side. Everything is protected against the sun. And during the night, it becomes a light building. So that is an invention of a shape. But this shape has an history. It's a consequence of Nicosia's story. It's linked to this situation. You see the facade when you have the base. You see all these differences linked to offices, to apartments after, to different nuances in the design of the apartments. And when you are in the south, you have the saturation of the terraces by the vegetation. And it's not finished. It will be better with the time, because the vegetation and landscape is a vertical landscape. We need time to give depth and to the building itself. And you see the building also is concrete. It's concrete with lime above. Lime exists in the country since centuries. We put lime, and the technique is, of course, possible because of a lot of progress, but it's also a continuity. It's also something deeper and deeper with the time. You see the integration of the building from different angles. Detail of facade, and you see inside the patio with the filters, with the landscape. Everyone has his landscape. During the night, of course, you have the contre-jour. And sometimes vegetation grows out and up. It's little pleasure. The pleasure to live here is the first will of the architect. Architecture is an art, and it's for this reason I am here. Dakis knows that his architecture is an art. That is a different typologies and programs. You see all the little perforation in all the walls around, and you see the typologies of the ground floor and with retail and the entrance of the offices, vegetation around, new landscape, and framing always on the neighbors, like a different perception. The fragmentation give a special attractivity to this surrounding. Ambiences are different at every level. Scale is different also. On the side, with this internal patio, lateral patio, you see here the north's openness. You see here offices with different organization, a random organization with closed offices, open offices. At the head of the building, little office. Every time is different. And when you are here, you are like in an apartment, in a house, with a garden in front on the lateral way. Different kinds of offices also. And the vision on the added development and the future main square of the city. You see the added work. You see internal scale, unexpected, I think. Landscape, growing. And we will arrive progressively to the top. That is apartment when you arrive. Apartment like house. You see the mountains, the city. You can open that totally. Levels and the collector apartment. The view is more open, of course, because we are at the top. You see a part of the wonderful collection. You see a spartiate little lounge. And here you go to the terrace, the ultimate terrace also the roof. Always protected against the sun. We have to play with the sun for the pleasure. A lot of variations of spaces, a lot. Special framing always. Every window is like a painting also. Thank you very much.